see what TL wants to pick into it. For Jensen specifically, we want to see a step up from game number one. Power of Evil felt like he had so many big plays for TSM. While Jensen
have been doing so much work with this godlike bottom side duo of the Aphelios plus Thresh. Hooney, though, going to be in trouble.
Hooney taking a lot of damage here. Santorin goes with him with the blast cone. Jumping right back in, nearly kills him off. Where's that last spear going to be? Hooney is here. He's got 50 health. He just popped his shield and he's overheated. Alfari's walking forward. Could just go for the flash. Q and first blood for Alfari.
So going to be a bit of a rebuttal there for Team Liquid. Core JJ gets the hook.
Okay, Sword Art now put in a bad spot where he has to flash back over the wall to get to his team. Holy cow, Tactical just jumping in on top of three. What was that? Because it wasn't the right move.
Malphite sighting!
The initiation supports will be initiating here, and it's Core JJ who's further away from the rest of the team, but now re-engaging here with the dredge line, and there with the front line, it's Sword Art going to be bursted down. Speak and taking the damage now with the ulti coming through. Aphelios doing some work, but Tactical doing more. Coming right back in there, and it's the Gangplank ulti that did so much here for TL in this fight. It gave him a 3-for-1. Now it's going to be 4 if they don't look out. Power of Evil gets charmed up. Triple kill over to Santorin and Team Liquid. What is it with these?
Does not flinch. He immediately hooks in. Jensen now, though, does not have ult, still has flash.
Flashing away, trying to get out of Hooney's damage. You are not getting away from anything. Yeah.
This man does not flinch, okay? You're running at him with Udyr. You throw the hook at him. He just turns it around. Such a good counter engage by Core.
You feel like you caught him out. He is so adept at recognizing when he can turn a play around. Now coming into the mid lane, going after Power of Evil. They know he already used his cleanse there on the bottom side, and Core JJ said thanks.
Down from Nautilus, clean exchange. They didn't even have to get into tower damage range there. Only one shot. Now Hooney's under fire as well.
Oh, but he drops down the equalizer to try to protect himself a little bit further. They grab the kill. Spica wants to move in there and see if anything can be here. He did have to stop off for the Seekers. Went for the Sorcerer Shoes as well for the early penetration. Now TSM might have to be careful with Team Liquid coming to make a play. They're recognizing that this Drake is still a win condition for them in a game that they're pretty significantly behind. And they want to keep this stack alive. They want to bring themselves onto the soul point here. Alfari's coming in for the damage. Jensen around from the side. It is a massacre. TSM, they wanted to try to continue stacking these up, but Team Liquid simply said no. Hooney's trying to stay close enough to maybe try to contest something, but it cannot be done. It's Drake plus 3 for TL.
You can just look at the player movement on that play, Flowers, and tell TSM are in just deep, deep, deep trouble right now. I mean, as soon as TL popped the Gangplank ultimate, every TS member is like, yep, nope, we gotta run, we're out of here. They're
see
all
later.
Grouped up, same pathway out, just AoE down. They knew there's very little hope for them. They get cut off on the only win condition left open to them in this game because it or something, because as immediately as Team Liquid show themselves, they're like, okay, we're outgunned here.
Alfari loses the turret that he's using as protection, but instead it was only a bait. Bringing Santorin down here for the 2v2, but now Team Liquid has lost a little bit more HP than they were expecting. The barrel's denied. Now Fari has to flash. Culling coming down. One shut down over to Power of Evil. Will it be two? Not just yet, but a bad stasis from Santorin could put him in a bad spot instead. Wait! What? What? What?
Or is it Captain Flowers? It is a stasis to bait once again. Honestly, it's an execution. He never got to hit the rumble. Tactical is gonna make up for earlier.
Okay, so Tactical grabs a freebie here in the mid lane, takes down the enemy AD carry in the 1v1. Meanwhile, on the bottom side, a stasis.
Don't you want to come tower dive over here? Alfari will screen the rest of TSM. He should be able to keep them out long enough, but 3k health and they're going for the fight.
Not against the equalizer. That thing is incredibly effective at stopping these early Baron attempts, but it will not be able to stop the fight and the kill afterwards. Tactical is on a
turret shot, two turret shot. He's able to hop away. He lands the spear onto PoE, so he gets credit for the kill onto PoE. Hooney was untouched, so it was an execution, but those still give over experience, and it's back out to Team Liquid. All that's really left for them is to finish up the dirty work, clearing up this map. They have the Everfrost Ahri, so with their control of Summoner's Rift, you just have to go set up at every objective first once again. Jensen can threaten to pick. And CoreJJ has the point and click that both POE and Lost have.
Six for CoreJJ's Nautilus, just having a much better game than his opponent this time around. Goes for the flash, dredge line, gets him through the flash. CoreJJ here in the front line now with the damage coming down. Core just might fall, yes he will, but the reset's coming through. Tactical does it again, he goes too far in. But he stays alive well enough to get away. Yes, he's got 200 HP left. Oh no, Speaker just runs it on into the waiting maw.
That is Team Liquid. Will get the dragon after it though. Tactical making good use of that W key.
Team Liquid has shaken off whatever bad vibes they had in game number one. And now CoreJJ once again going back in for the counter engage as soon as it looks like he's been caught out. But was it a mistake this time? Jensen and Santorin both going to be taken low. TSM health bar is about to evaporate from a little bit more damage, but they cannot get the reset. Tactical cannot get a kill. Alfari goes in looking for even more. He's going to grab the bullet that kills off Spica. Everybody on TSM.
Possibilities. TSM are not lying down. They're continuing to throw counterpunch after counterpunch, and now Alfari is next on the menu.
Alfari's seeing the rumble and saying, all right, I can fight this guy, but League of Legends is a team game, my friend. So now you got to get away from one, two, three, four, and that's not
halfway.
They know they need something like this to get them back into this game. Team Liquid moving forward as four, trying to stop them. Multi-man stun coming out here with the Everfrost. Baron down to about 1,000 HP. It's going to be secured by Hooney. Santorin's into the pit, buying a little bit of time here with the stasis. Getting back out over the wall. Team Liquid coming in, looking to fight, but Lost is going crazy here with the Aphelios damage. But not crazy enough. It is a quadra kill for Jensen and an ace for Team Liquid.
Well, that's the end of that story. Tactical is able to finish it off. Team Liquid can now push in towards an inhibitor. TSM group up all in the back of the barrel. Bunch of easy fish for the shooting there as Team Liquid. They are initially turned back by this Rumble ultimate from Hooney, which was quite good on the line outside of Baron Pit, but then they just re-engaged.
Such a good job starting that off there for Team Liquid, making sure that they captured everybody in the back part of the pit there as Baron is doing extra damage. Free firing time onto this. Jensen goes over the wall, just buys their attention for a moment to give Tactical the chance to put the autos into the turret, and there's the bomb, there's the damage, and there's the second inhibitor broken open now on the side of TSM. Yes, the inhibitor itself still remains, but they've got a lot of protecting to do when they're down 9,500 gold.
Yeah, and they don't have any issues with sustain either. With three Ocean Dragons themselves, it's not the soul yet, but it's still decent sustain for the Team Liquid members. They keep up the pressure outside of the inhibitor here and can keep TSM bottled up inside their own. Whoop.
Oh, CoreJJ tries to go in, but with the equalizer called down yet again, Hooney's got a lot of ability haste here. So that means that that was ready to go, and it stops Team Liquid from going all the way in. CoreJJ throwing down the ulti, but Hooney instantly with the stasis, trying to get himself away from the aggro. Jensen goes in with the Everfrost, finds the CC on a Sword Art. The inhibitor falls. Nobody from TSM is dead. That's the important to put Team Liquid in a similar situation. They need another one of those tactical decisions out of this Tristana. CoreJJ taking a lot of damage here in the front line, getting caught out a little bit. Gets away to safety as the Gangplank ulti finds everybody on the side of TSM. Jensen goes forward. Everfrost going to find some CC and damage onto two. Hooney into the stasis. Sword Art's already down as he drops the box. But Jensen has gone godlike with a charm into a spear. And power of evil, Lost, Spica, everybody's trying to get away, but they aren't getting away from nothing. Tactical's going in for the reset city as Spica and power of evil stand 2v5, but they will not stand any longer. Nexus turret's fallen over. Team Liquid on the victory march, significantly faster than game number one. They'll even look to pad the stats here at the very end. They are confident. This one is all done for, and Team Liquid move up to a 2-0 lead.
Interesting game number two.